Well, it wiped out the security for us, but...
Well, look at that. Wolfie's got the crest of Aminoch, the same pendant worn by priestesses.
Then that makes this demon...
Yeah, she must be the missing mother, Mahina.
It can't be...
Don't just stand there! It's gonna eat you!
I know that!
Loved by her village, would become a demon.
Eleanor?
She's never going to be the same again. This is the least I can do for her. So says Reason.
Huh? That feeling.
Damn!
Let the demon be. We don't need it.
Demon. I guess she caught demon blight when she was looking for her daughter.
Yeah, that's what the girl at the inn said.
But even after turning into a demon, she's still searching for her daughter. Well, Rokuro, Korogane, and Dial all remember what they wanted when they were human, right? Demon or not, she's a mother. It's no surprise she would still be protective of her child.
It could be that, or it could be something else.
Well, I hope that's what it is.
I know that must be how she felt as a human, but demons don't have a sense of motherhood or any such thing. You saw how violent she was. She's not Mahina anymore. When she became a demon, she lost all capacity for empathy and love. It's heartbreaking, but it's the truth.
Velvet and Rokuro still have empathy.
One demon left unchecked could take 100 lives, and this one's even willing to attack exorcists. Demons can wipe out entire villages, even cities, just as they destroyed my village. Thus, my path is clear.
Eleanor is right. There's no turning back once you've changed. Perhaps it would be a mercy to grant her peace through death. Huh. Is Inomi not really an Empyrean?
What makes you ask that all of a sudden?
Well, according to the song Grimm deciphered, Inomi not is an eight-headed dragon, right? The Empyreans are supposed to be these holy beings, but using Therians to feed on malevolence sounds more sinister than divine to me.
You've got a point there. Empyreans are a type of Malakim, and that doesn't seem like any Malak we've seen. And even less so when we're talking an eight-headed dragon.
Is it so far-fetched?
What do you think will happen if the Therians come together in one place?
Well, it wouldn't be good. My guess is they'd merge together into a giant, horrific monster. The mighty beast will attack us with its eight long, snake-like necks and eight heads spitting hellfire!
I can see your worry.
Right? And that's eight heads with only six of us to take them on. It'd be more than we could handle.
I'd have to conjure up a double or two.
You can do that?
Of course not.
Then why mention it?
Oh!
What is it, Lafayette?
Do you think each head would act of its own free will? Because if they do, they'd be uncoordinated, bumping into each other and going this way and that, giving us an opening. If we fight as one united whole, I know we can win!
Yes! If we work hand in hand, victory is ours! Right, everyone?
Huh? Us? United? Have you looked at us recently?
Well, I mean, maybe...
Well, there you are.
That barrier again!
Looks like we were right. Another Therian. Just as Velvet conjectured, each of the seven heads seems to assume a different form.
The sensation! It was here!
Oh, look at that. I guess your hunch panned out too, kiddo.
This is just how I felt in Ward Forest. That must have been an Earth Pulse point back there, too.
Well, what are we going to do with this one? Can we get it to shrink like that bug of yours?
I don't care whether it lives or dies. As long as we defeat it and take out one of Enominot's heads, that's all that matters.
Try not to let it eat you.
That'd be very uncomfortable.
I don't think this Therian's getting any smaller.
Must refer to demons, then.
Feeding on demons. I know what that's like.
Mommy. Mommy.
Look! It turned into a little girl!
Is that... Kamoana?
Mommy, why? Why did you leave me all alone? Did I do something wrong? Was I too weak? I'm sorry, Mommy. I'm sorry.
No, this can't be happening.
I tried so hard to be strong for you, Mommy. The man from the Abbey made me strong. So please, Mommy. Please come back.
The Abbey made her strong?
By turning her into a Therian? Jeez, those Abbey jokers really get off on this sacrifice stuff, don't they?
I can't believe it. That woman, she was trying to save her own daughter.
Mommy! Mommy! I miss you. Mommy!
dying, unable to save her daughter. All she could do was offer herself to feed her hungry child.
No! This is my fault!
So, should we bring her with us?
Someone like her will only slow us down.
That Therian isn't going anywhere!
Oscar! What is the Abbey doing? Please tell me, I have to know!
Eleanor, the less you know, the better.
I must know! I killed her mother, and then the poor girl, she...
Ah, so she must have devoured the demon. But don't let that trouble you. The demon was a necessary sacrifice to bring an end to this world's pain and suffering.
It wasn't just some demon! She was a mother! She was all this girl had! Her one and only mother.
Be that as it may, those who possess strong wings must...
It's not nice to make a girl cry.
Mommy!
Kamoana.
It's now or never.
Out of the way, Lafayette.
Wait! Have you no compassion?
This isn't up for discussion.
I thought you just wanted to weaken an Omanaut! You can sever the link! You don't have to kill her! Velvet!
Oh, someone's had a change of heart. Apparently, a woman's tears truly do have frightening power.
I'm just curious about something Grimoire said. I can always kill this one later.
If we're taking her with us, we'd better grab her and go. No sense lingering in the enemy's territory.
Hey, Kamoana. My name's Lafayette. Do you want to come with me and my friends and get out of here?
Where's my mommy? I'll be lonely without her. You're not alone, sweetie. I promise. Even if she's far away, your mother will always be looking over you.
How do you know?
Because... that's what my mother does for me, too.
Let's go, Kamoana.
Okay.
Grim, what's up? Did you come to share something else you found in that book?
Not quite. I'm afraid the malevolence has grown too dense for me to hole up at the inn reading.
Malevolence?
The hell? What's that coming out of their bodies?
Malevolence. They're all hitting their limits.
Demon Blight! Even the Inn Girl! Why is this happening?
They're demons now.
Their malevolence is spilling over.
The malevolence? All of that energy spilling from their bodies? That's what causes the demon blight?
Do you know what demon blight really is? What demons are?
They couldn't have gotten far! Track them down at all costs!
We'll talk later. The Exorcists are going to have their hands full with these demons. Let's get back to the ship while we can.
My mom!
Come, Alana. Your mother is still far away.
Then I need to wait for her at home. Let's go back to Haria.
Scary demons are running through the village. It's too dangerous there now.
But I want to see my mom.
Your mom would be sad if you got hurt by a demon. Come with us, and we'll keep you safe until she comes back.
Okay, I'll go with you. I wouldn't want Mom to be sad.
All right. You're going to tell me about the demon blight and malevolence. Are you seriously thinking of breaking the Moloch taboo?
That depends.
Moloch taboo?
This is about more than just the demons. You could say it's the truth behind how this world really works. The knowledge can be devastating to humans, throwing into question everything they think they know. And so the Malachim agreed to withhold it from humans, for their own protection.
Do you still want to know?
It's not like I'm a human anymore.
I can't keep lying to myself. I can't go on unless I know the truth.
You asked for it. First of all, this thing, this illness you call demon blight, does not exist. Any human carries the potential of becoming a demon. All it takes is for the malevolence lurking in their heart to overflow.
And what exactly is this malevolence?
Impure emotions beyond what reason can suppress. Think of it as the sin buried in men's souls.
So you knew.
I'm a witch. So malevolence is the darkness in all our hearts. Make any sense to you guys? Any at all?
When you put it like that, yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
By nature, humans are incited by negative energy. It is easy to turn them towards impurity, creating malevolence. In fact, most people are constantly generating malevolence.
It might even be possible that demons are people's true selves, and what little reason they possess is all that keeps them in human form.
If the masses realize this, the realm would be thrown into utter chaos. That's why the Abbey propagates the lie of demon blight.
So I presume.
That can't be true! You know yourselves there weren't any demons before the opening!
It used to be that humans couldn't see demons, or Malachim. Not unless they possessed a unique spiritual talent we call resonance.
All your average human would see was someone turning extremely violent. Unable to explain what was happening, they just call those people possessed or feral.
Then what made people see them all of a sudden?
I don't know. My guess would be that something triggered greater resonance among all of humanity. And then, on the day of the Advent, all humans gained the ability to perceive Malachim. And in the following days, the Exorcist numbers swelled.
This has to be Artorias's doing.
But if there's no sickness, why would an entire village turn into demons at the same time?
Eight-headed is the lord of the land, with seven mouths to devour malevolence. Humans produce malevolence, which Therians consume and transmit to a Nominat. But when we removed Kamawana from the Earth Pulse Point...
Clever boy. That's right. With no Therian to absorb their malevolence, the villagers could no longer contain it.
So you're saying it's all my fault?
Hey, what's going on? You all look so sad. It's scaring me.
On the other hand, at least now we know we can trust the contents of that ancient book. We tear the Therians away from their Earth Pulse points. Enominat's power will wane, and will prevent this awakening.
But if we take away the Therians, then more and more humans will turn into demons.
It's the only way to kill Artorias.
Ooh, the knives come out!
So even the truth won't stop you. Very well.
Since each Therian looks different, we'll only find them by capturing the Earth Pulse points one by one.
What separates humans and demons?
That's Eleanor.
Cheer up, Eleanor. Your mommy's looking over you too, you know.
Yeah, so she is. Thank you, Kamawana.
Grimoire, I want you to tell me more about what you said earlier.
About malevolence? I told you, the subject is taboo.
I understand that human emotions create a poison called malevolence that turns people into demons. Is there no way to stop malevolence from being created?
As long as humans remain human, no. Malevolence is born of emotion, you see.
But your kind must have found a way around it. Malakim experience emotions too.
But Malakim do not produce malevolence, unlike humans.
That's a lie. I've watched a Moloch turn into a demon.
That only happens when we are exposed to too much external malevolence.
True. The island was full of prisoners and demons. And Melchior hit that Moloch with something that turned it into a wyvern. Was it malevolence?
To Malakim, malevolence is a powerful toxin. We seek those of purity to serve as vessels to protect us from it. It is not a perfect solution, however.
If the vessel is corrupted, the Moloch is as well.
That is correct.
So if Eleanor turns into a demon, then Lafayette... That must be what Aizen meant when he said he'd hate to see Lafayette's vessel broken.
A small crack in one's soul is often all it takes to break a person apart. So try not to pick on our squeaky clean exorcist too much, hmm?
Thanks for the warning.
Sir, we just received a Sylph-Jay from the boss of the Bloodwings. She has a job for us and wants us to meet her in Logris. How should we respond?
Let's do it. Besides, we need to see if that demon in the villa was actually a Therian.
Good point. And the Bloodwings might know something about the other Therians, too. We're heading for Logris. Prepare to set sail.
Ready anytime!
I lost my mother to a demon. Yet that girl's a Therian. I don't even know what I want anymore.
Hey, that's pretty!
You like to look at that thing, don't you?
Yes, My mother... Someone very important to me gave me this. I treasure it a lot. Looking at it gives me strength. Do you want to see it?
Yeah!
Ah! What's wrong?
My face! It's scary! I don't want to look like that! I don't want my mommy to hate me! Mommy! Mommy!
When I was her age, that's just how I cried. Come, Alana. I want you to see this.
That huge owie. What happened?
It's big and ugly, isn't it? There are scary things about my body, too. But do you think I'm scary, Kamalana?
No, not at all. But are you all right? Does that hurt?
Thanks, sweetie. I'm all right, I promise.
What about me? Do you think I'm scary?
You're such a sweetheart, Kamalana. Nobody could ever be scared of you. Not me, not your mother, not Lafayette. You don't have to cry anymore. It'll be okay. I promise.
Okay.
That scar, was it from a demon?
Yeah. They attacked my village when I was a girl. I was so hurt, I couldn't move. But my mother lured them away from me so I could survive.
What happened to her?
The last thing she said to me was, "Stay strong and keep living."
Oh.
Come to the deck. Grimoire says she's learned something from the book. Hey, why's your face so red?
It's nothing.
Somehow I doubt that.
It's nothing, I swear.
Do you all remember the second verse of that song Lafayette read earlier?
Four Empyreans may tear him asunder, but so long as there is one receptive to divine power, Therian shall be forever reborn in sight of the full crimson moon.
Right. That's what I've gathered you all here to discuss. And we think that passage means that Enominach and the Therians will be revived by a chosen one, right? Yes, but the shall be forever reborn part kept bothering me. I've reconsidered my analysis. Suppose that instead of someone being chosen by Enominach to create Therians, the song means that Enominach chooses who becomes Therians. But so long as there is one receptive to divine power, Therians shall be forever reborn. What do you think that could mean? That someone receptive to Enominach's power will be reborn as a Therian.
Like Kamalana.
Which is to say that the Abbey figured out how to turn people into Therians, and then got right to work.
That's...
Are you really that surprised? Artorias has always been one to prioritize the many over the individual, as I well know. Another thing to consider is this wording about Therians being forever reborn. This could mean that one Therian will be reborn again and again. Or it could mean that different Therians will be born to take their place. Meaning that even if you kill one, there are more waiting in line. They can't be wiped out.
Looks like prioritizing the one over the many was the right call this time, eh, Velvet?
I never said I wouldn't kill her, if it would prevent Enominach's reawakening. But Therians can't be killed. Not truly.
So, in a nutshell, if you kill one, another person who's receptive to Enominach's power will be reborn as one.
Right. But the song says that seven mouths feed the body. So there's only so many around.
If you don't kill them, the next ones won't be born.
Exactly. So we remove the seven Therians from their Earth Pulse points instead. But then, We also have to protect them so the Abbey doesn't steal them back or kill them.
Sounds tricky. We've got to protect my bug, too.
Yeah, you take real good care of that thing now. Got it?
You bet I will.
In that case, we should probably work on securing a proper hideout for ourselves. You got a secret base or anything, Aizen?
It's every man's fantasy, but sadly, I don't.
We need a hard-to-find spot. One where we can guarantee a steady supply of malevolence for the Therians.
Somewhere devoid of people but full of malevolence. Real poser you got there.
With the Abbey in control of the entire continent, finding a place like that will be easier said than done.
Meanwhile, Enominat's reawakening draws ever closer. We'll have to keep collecting our Therians while we search for a hideout. For now, let's just get to Logris.
All the water and food you got.
Wait your turn, moron. I was drifting out at sea for 3 days. Almost died out there.
Wee-hee, poor you. You probably deserved it.
Say that again, wise ass. I dare ya.
Shut up, both of ya. No one's getting anything until you pay me what you owe first.
Are they gonna be okay?
Don't pay them any mind. Sailors are just a short-tempered bunch, that's all.
Huh? The hell are you doing?
What's going on?
They've jacked up the price to dock our ship here.
Oh yeah? Some real balls you've got there, buddy.
If you lot want to moor here, that's the price you're gonna pay. Look, pirates are a liability to begin with, but calling your crew infamous these days would be putting it lightly. The more wanted you are, the more it's gonna cost to hide you. Capiche?
Hard to argue there. Benwick, just pay the man what he wants.
Yes, sir. You're such pushovers. You and the captain both.
I knew I could count on you to come through, Aizen. Pleasure doing business with you.
Looks like I'm causing you trouble.
It comes with the job. Don't sweat it. Some sailors just have longer tempers than others.
Noted.